Scrivener 3 for Windows has so many features, it's hard to keep them all straight. So in this video, I'm going to cover the top 10 features that Scrivener 3 for Windows users need to know about. My name is Michael Laron with AuthorLevelUp.com, helping you write better stories faster and feel good doing it. Now, this is not an ordered list, but stay tuned to the end because I do have a bonus 11th tip that you definitely don't want to miss. Tip number one is revision mode. To access revision mode, we're going to go to Format, and then we're going to select revision mode. And then to give you an example, we'll select first revision. What that allows me to do is start typing on the screen, and you'll see that the future text that I type is in red. Now, if I go to Format and revision mode and second revision, you'll notice that next draft I do is in blue. So this way I can tell that everything in black is my first draft, everything in red is my first revision, everything in blue is my next revision. And if I want to turn these off, all I have to do is go to revision mode and remove all revisions. Tip number two is the threaded corkboard. Scrivener has offered a corkboard for a very long time, but now it has even additional functionality. So if I go to the corkboard and I click on this little thread icon here, this organizes my corkboard into a timeline. And if I have a story with multiple POVs or multiple characters, I can now color code each of those timelines. And as I go through the story here, I can see that I have character A on the top and then character B in red. And you can continue this throughout your story, and it's a great way to see everything visually. Now, if I wanted to switch back, I can just click this threaded icon here on the bottom again, and I'm back to the regular corkboard. Tip number three is writing history. Let's say I've had a great writing day and I want to know how many words I wrote today, but I also want to know how many words I wrote yesterday. I can go to Project and select Writing History, and this will give me my word counts for every single day, which is great. And I can even show the history in words or characters. I can do months and days, or months only, or days only. And it gives me my average down here. And even better, if I wanted to, if I dared, I could export this to a CSV file and bring it into Excel and do additional data analysis. Tip number four is copy holders. Get up to four split screens at the same time. Now, Scrivener for Windows has always had a split screen version, and if I click on this little toggle button right here, it activates the split screen. So I can change this to chapter 2 and scroll and edit and scroll and edit. All that's great. You've seen that. And if I hold the Alt key while I press this button, I can go from vertical to horizontal, which is great. Now, if I go over to the binder and I select chapter 3 and I hold the Option key and drag it into this little bar up here. Boom, look at that. I've got a third split screen, and I can resize the window down here like that. And I can do the same thing with chapter 4. Hold the Option key, drag it into this little bar here, and boom, I have four split screens. How cool is that? We're halfway through our list, but don't forget, we have a special 11th bonus feature coming up at the end of this video. Tip number five, which is a short one, is the bookmarks feature. Bookmarks is a great feature. It just allows you to go back to sections that you may visit regularly. So let's say chapter one is a chapter I want to go back to regularly because there's important things that happen there. All I have to do is click chapter one and drag it into this little bookmark icon right here. And then if I go to chapter seven and oh, I want to jump back to chapter one, I could click here and go back that way, but I could just also click here and I can go back to chapter one. And if I double click, it opens up in a new window. But if I don't double click it and just click it once, it takes me back here. So it's a great way to be able to jump around, give you some additional flexibility. Tip number six is linguistic focus. Now, linguistic focus is one of my favorite features, and we can access it by going to Edit, and then all the way down here to Writing Tools, and then Linguistic Focus right here. And then it only supports direct speech right now, but if I click this little fade button, you'll notice as I fade this in and out that the direct speech appears in darker colors. So I can fade this all the way out and then scroll through the story and I can only see the dialogue. How cool is that? This makes editing so much easier. Tip number 7 is the assisted search menu, which makes it easier to find things. This is a helpful feature to remember all the different features that Scrivener has, because sometimes I find that I forget where some feature is. I forget what window it's tucked under. So I can go to help here, and then I can go to search menus, and then you can type in what you're looking for. So let's talk about linguistic focus. I forgot where that is. So I type it in, and then it tells me where it is, and I click on it, and then it comes up. It's an amazing feature. It'll help you save some time. And if you're a new user to Scrivener, this is a great way to be able to get around without having to memorize where everything is. Tip number 8 is the hidden search bar. This is a great feature, but it's hidden. So if I hover my mouse over this chapter 1 bar up here, it gives me a word count, which is great. But if I click on it, boom, I can do a search. And let's say I want to search for the term rat. Well, it just gives me all of the search results where it is, and I can click on that and it'll take me to where it is in the story. Amazing. Tip number 9 is the speech feature, which will let Scrivener read your stories to you. Now, I know some of you like to edit and have your story read to you or listen to it because it helps you uncover different errors than if you were reading it and just looking at it on screen. And so Scrivener will read your story to you if you like. So if I select this text here and then I right click and I go to speech and start speaking, let's take a listen.
Cyrus Grant tumbled blindly through the storm sewer, fighting for his life. Somewhere beneath the streets of Chicago, his animal form agitated round and round like a balled up sock in a washing machine.
Tip number 10 is themes, including a brand new dark mode. I don't know about the rest of you, but I don't know how I ever lived without dark mode. So Scrivener now supports it. So I can go to Window and I can go to Themes, and then I can select any number of modes here as well as import modes of my own. Now, the only thing you have to remember is that you have to restart Scrivener in order to use these. So as I talk here, I'm going to flash these different modes up on the screen. I personally happen to like the dark mode. I think that pops, but there are a lot of other modes, and I highly recommend you just experiment, take 5 minutes or 10 minutes or so, and just try the different types of modes and figure out which one works for you. I know some people love the mellow yellow mode. That's just not for me. It just reminds me of ketchup and mustard. But maybe that is your thing, or maybe you're a Violet Hayes person. Check it out. Let me know what you think. So those are the top 10 features that you need to know about as a Scrivener 3 for Windows user. Now, for that 11th bonus tip, and you're probably wondering about the 11th bonus tip. What is that, Michael? Well, it is updated document targets. Now, to access the new and improved document targets, what I can do here is click this little bullseye down here on the bottom right of the screen. And when I click that, it allows me to set a target for this particular document. So this chapter is 1,036 words. So just humor me for a moment and I'll do 1,037 words. And we can also show our allowance in the progress bar, which is just a great visual way of seeing where you're at. And then I'm gonna do show target notifications. And let's see what happens. So you can see here that in the bottom, now the progress bar is pretty much done because I'm almost there. And then if I click a word, let's say I click and add a word. Oh, look at that. I just got a notification that I hit my target. Oh, this is such a great feature for NaNoWriMo and something that did not exist in Scrivener 1. I wanna hear from you. Let me know what your favorite Scrivener 3 for Windows feature is, or if there's something here I didn't mention. And if you want more videos on Scrivener 3 for Windows, there's another one coming right up.